Hey guys, this is MJK from WebStylePress.com. If this is your first time here, I share useful stuff for devs at this channel. Join this channel by hitting subscribe button and bell icon. There are two simple things in React that will annoy you a lot and again and again. Number one is key. You know, key. You forgot to specify the key. And number two, multiple elements should not be in, should be in single wrapper or similar to something like this. Very, very irritating and annoying warnings. And you know what? Your code should not have even warnings. Console should be clean, let alone errors. Warnings can also keep your app from pushing to production, and linter will keep your code in development unless you clean all the warnings. So let's talk about these, and let me reproduce some funny issues related to this topic. I have got this app created with the Create React app, and this is already created, and it has got simple use state, use effect hooks, and this is our storage area, our state area, data and set data in the use state. And then I have got use effect, and here it is, this function, and I am repeating this again, guys. Use this thing when you use effect. All right, this will keep your code from going into an infinite loop. Okay, use this. This is the dependency injection area. But if you don't have dependencies, even then use it and keep it empty. Okay, so load data, and this is our function that is being called in the use effect, and it is using async and await. These two keywords, async before the function, and await will keep this function waiting for this call to return. And then this is a fetch, so it is promise based. So we are getting this data from JSON placeholder, and in response then we are receiving the data, and we are setting the data, received data, here inside the data, right? And then we are just calling this data here and mapping this data and mapping records from it, and keys. Let me change the title for this. Let me use HR here. Okay, so data, this is coming from here, from the state, and data dot map record, and here is our key. We have used div, and this is the name and the username from the data, and we have got, I can show you what we have got in the data. We have got some records, and we have got ID, name, username, email address. This is the simple records, right? Or this is an object, and we are mapping it and displaying the two records here. Okay, so let's convert this div into, let's say we have got a table here. Let's use table here. So table, and here the table will be ended, and instead of this div, let's use tr, and here tr, and then here td, and then here again td. Okay, so okay, same thing, we have got the result, but we have got something here. TR cannot appear as a child of table. Added TBody. All right, so let's use TBody here, and here is our TBody, and now okay, parsing error expected corresponding JSX. This TBody will be closed. So let's close it, and now we have got our data. Okay, now let's consider that we have got two rows here instead of one, and one has got the name and the second has got the username, and this is the key ID. Let's use name here as key. Okay, so let's see. All right, so here is the error, what it says. So this is our first warning, first error. It is an error, parsing error. Adjacent JSX elements must be wrapped in an enclosing tag. Adjacent JSX elements. So these are the adjacent side by side two JSX elements must be wrapped in an enclosing tag. All right. So you enclose these in now these are the TRs. Okay. You cannot use div anything, any element like div or anything. Okay. Do not break the proper structure of the HTML. Okay. HTML will be invalid. So TR, two TRs can be inside TBody, or you can use this thing here, fragment, empty fragment, or whatever we call it. Save. All right, so what it says now, so our error has got changed. Parsing error expected corresponding JSX closing tag. We didn't close it. So let's close it and let's see now. The error should be gone now. All right, so error gone. We can see the data, but we have got another error. Each child in a list should have a unique key prop, but we have given the keys to these TRs. Keys are here. Now we need a key here as well. So this is an empty thing, it cannot have a key. So another thing to use is react.fragment. I believe this is the way to write it. Let's see. Okay, so it will work, and here we can specify the key. Now we can remove the keys from here, and we can specify the key only here. So now the error has gone. So these two things, one, that adjacent elements, adjacent JSX element should be wrapped in a wrapper element, and the second thing is this key. So you may not see scenario like this, or you may not have to work on a scenario like this, but you never know. You know, clients are crazy sometimes. Even managers are crazy sometimes. They ask to do funny stuff. You can have scenario like this, believe me. And one thing that I am looking at this scenario, this particular scenario, we may even not need this because we have the T-body and that can wrap the two adjacent elements. And we can use the key at the T-body. I think T-body can serve the purpose for us here. And let's see. Yeah, T-body is all right to use here. T-body will serve the purpose. T-body is fine to use. Yeah, but take care of these two issues. And you may encounter these two things again and again while coding with reactjs. So enclose your adjacent JSX element in a wrapper element always. And if you don't want to use any element particularly like div or anything, you can just use this empty, these empty brackets. These empty brackets or react.fragment. This will be closed here. Or react.fragment. Okay. So react.fragment and these empty brackets are kind of same thing. And these won't render any element, any tag in the output, right? These are just the ghost wrappers, you can say. These will wrap, but these won't show up in the output, in the DOM, in the final output, okay? So these are safe to use. And for this particular example, you could use the T-body anyways, and there should be a key. Key should be in the main element inside the map, where if you are mapping stuff, then first element should have a key, or each element that is being rendered in loop or being mapped should have a unique key, and adjacent elements should be wrapped in a wrapper. So these are two things to care about, right? So that's it, guys. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything or you have something to add, you can comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.